Back into society's mask in society's way.
And the truth is that it's all a facade. There's a face that we hide till the night time appears.
And what's hiding inside behind all of our fears
is our true self, locked inside a facade.
Matter of vital interest to any enlightened member of society.
Dr. Chapman,
May we dispense with the niceties and proceed with the matter at hand.
Certainly, Mr. Stride. Forgive my good manners. Distinguished governors, in each of us there reside two separate natures, two distinct personalities, one dark, one light, one good, one evil. It is the curse of mankind that these two extremes should be constantly at war.
I think you should let your
It is clear to me now that we have the power to divide this primitive duality of man into its separate components, to isolate what is functional from what is dysfunctional, and to control these elements forever. My experiments with various animals have convinced me that the separation, the behavioral control of which I speak, is more than theoretical. It is achievable. I must be permitted now to test my procedure and my formula on a human subject.
A human Right.
Yes, gentlemen, I ask that I be permitted to select a patient who will help me to prove my theory for the betterment of all mankind. A volunteer, I hope.
A volunteer mental patient. Very good.
The man whom society has already abandoned as hopeless, and it may come this prison.
Prison?
And you would perform your surgery on this pitiable creature's brain?
No! As I have already explained to this august body, my treatment takes the form of rare drugs, precisely combined, administered through hypodermic injection. There are doomed broken souls in a thousand asylums, left there to rot for the lack of a plan. There are doomed broken souls in a thousand asylums, left there to rot for the lack of a plan. In the name of compassion and medical science, I can save many lives. If you give me one man,
I tell you now, the church will never sanction it.
Sacrilege, lunacy, blasphemy, heresy.
Beware, sir, you're treading on dangerous ground. In legal terms, I'd say extremely unsound. Your lack of humility strikes me as odd. What makes you think you have a right to be God?
Bishop speaks for all of us when he says you're playing God. There's such a thing as ethics. Over which you ride roughshod. You've never seen, you've never tickled for a start. What I judge from your behavior, you can't tell the two apart.
Mr. Stride, I am simply a scientist. I have a code to which I remain true. I don't presume to the stature of moralist. I leave a pension like that, sir, to you.
Henry, I've always encouraged your enterprise. And I've been hopeful that you would succeed. But given the problems my colleagues can visualize, I see no choice but for you to concede.
I know my fate is yours to choose, but if I fail, the world will lose when I am on the threshold of success. I beg you, governess, you must say yes.
Dr. Chipley, help with your writing, sir. This is a hospital here to see you.
Change. The only thing constant
is change. Distinguished colleagues, your verdict, please. All those in favor, say aye. All those opposed, nay.
If Jekyll's as clever as you say he is, what's he doing trying to save all? let alone a madman.
I think he's mad, if you must know. Danvers, we're talking about your future son-in-law. I think you're mad to let him marry your daughter. It's not father's decision, Lady Beaconsfield. It's mine.
You're right, Bessie. Whatever your opinion of him as a scientist may be, Emma assures me every gentle is impeccable husband material.
But for a start, it is less than impeccable to be able one's own an engagement party. Shows a remarkable lack of style.
Bessie.
Comments on style should never be made by those who have none.
Miss Cabrera.
Thank you for being here, Miss Thomas.
You are a bracing breath of fresh air. Emma Carew, this be you? What kind of man is this you take? Can you not see the kind of life this would be? You are mistaken. Time to awaken before it's too late. Before you forever determine your fate.
But Simon, you knew I had to be free. What I choose to do. Decided by me. From the day my mother died, my father, full of good intentions, treated me as though I were a young child. Maybe his idea was just to wait until I grew up and then look to me and told that I'd be her. It's easy to accept that I'm a father. If all things remained the way they were. But when it comes to marriage, I must be whom I prefer.
Some mine. I will always understand how the path you put out.
escaped the horizon. Sure of my way, where I am going. But where's the prize? I have my eyes on. There is just no knowing, and when the spell tears me in two, can I turn to but you? You know who I am. You take me as I
I have to let you go.
He's too young, he just desperately needs something to drink.
He's friends to a life of debauchery.
I prefer to drink,
and I will, I think.
Why have you brought me here? You need the relaxation.
He is right, Henry. You need relaxation. Take for one a champagne for Miss Anderson's party. The show is a multi-star, Henry. You will love the show.
down to Old Red Bush.
Where were you?
Sir Marek, what's happening again?
If it does, it'll happen to a dead girl. And I mean that.
I know you do.
Lucky for you, I'm in a good mood tonight. We'll see you a little later on to show you just how good.
Be me.
Be good to it, Luce. Some news quality when they see it.
Anything more you need, sir?
you again this evening.
Good night, sir.
started this alone. I must finish it.
Alone?
I know that I must use myself as the subject of the experiment.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry, Miss Gould. Perhaps next week.
No, I want to be gentle. I'm not asked.
Emma, well, he asks about you constantly, Miss Gould. But he's not seen anybody not for weeks now. He calls.
Because of his work, yes, I know. Which I wouldn't have vowed to him. And there are some things I've lost to get his attention. So we have to remind him that there is more in his life than his work. Yes, I think.
Emma, talk. You weren't coming here again until you've been merchant.
I'm not.
This is absurd. He's sacrificing everything valuable in his life to this experiment.
This experiment is the most valuable thing in his life.
Huh?
I did push to allow Miss Rose, and it is hard for my wish. But for more than a week now, he has been locked in that laboratory. I have instructed to leave his meals at the door and go away.
He's been alone in there all this time.
Alone, sir? No.
But if you're forbidden to admit
it. I did not admit it, sir. The doctor must have let him in. I would not have admitted the man of that sort to the doctor's home. I saw him here just once. He was standing there in front of the fire, staring at his reflection. He told me to clear out, not to disturb him and the doctor again. And later that same night, well, I heard the doctor or someone in the laboratory. Right. Weeping, yes. The strangest sound you've ever heard, sir. And then I thought I heard something else.
I have been ready for a quarter of an hour, sir. Go to Mr. Bissett, the pharmacist, now and fetch me back these drugs.
No. Henry? Good Lord, what has happened to you?
No, fool!
It's looking as if you're in the grip of the very devil.
John, there's something you must do for me.
Assuming this insanity
is work.
It's more than work, it is a
Family?
I've got no family. You give me a card.
Yes.
I've had someone like you be nice to me before.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. That's what you are.
most extraordinary lady.
Thank you.
Yes, yes. I'd like to see her again next week.
Certainly, Your Grace. Happy to oblige. Must make a pleasant change from all your charity work. Of course, we don't do it for charity. Wednesday, all right.
Wednesday, very nice, sir. Goodbye for now, my dear.
And say cheerio to His Grace. Never mind her. She is stunned by your generosity. That is all. To Wednesday, then.
Your Grace, it warms the heart to have a romance that blossoms here in the sewers of her.
Oh, you
what a pretty bear. A Romeo the cloth and a Juliet of a gutter. But Juliet's a trifle young for such a disgusting old Romeo.
James, sir, do you know who I am?
Yes, Your Grace, I know exactly who you are. Eminent churchmen and philanthropists, friend of those in need, particularly upon the female gender and the years still tender.
Let
me come to that, the 14th bishop on base and stoke.
Oh,
yes, he's most distinguished. Degenerate, that same, corrupt, and malignant hypocrite. Fills my whole soul with its curse, burning with primitive fire, berserk and perverse. Tonight I'll thunder and blight you from all the gods to fate. I'll take all that I can build the arts, and I'll be your rival forever. And Satan himself by my side.
Yeah.
stop, Kenny. Irreplaceable.
I'm happy to inform you that you are relieved of your duties, sir. All of them.
Damn impertinence! Who in hellfire are you?
In hellfire. Exactly. That's another of you gone, Teddy.
It is another murder, just like that other murder. That's for all Jim will love him.
Last week that bishop caught him, that note that Johnny caught him, that fellow must be off his head. Let's do the last 4 days, this can last fancy ways.
I tried to save them, all of them.
tried my hell.
Of course you did. But that's a matter between you and God. God knows, and you know, that you tried. You have a safe church.
Thank you.
And I do love you.
I know that. And I won't wait however long it takes. But I will pray for you.
Someone I don't know. I fear
some monster drawing near to me, becoming clear to see. But what I fear to be
I have to go away for a little while.
instrument of Nemesis. There's a beast at the door and he's wild and dizzy. He's out to visit. He's scarcely done what to me. What is right behind
the song.
Henry?
Is it your message? I'm taking
minutes, I have one final chance to save myself. To control him. God help him, my friend. God help us all.
chance in life to find a new heart. Just a simple role that I play.
Saying goodbye. Are you strangers to my life. They are there in this place.
Silence will hide you. You cannot choose but to lose.
capture of his heart.
For God's sake, set me free. Set us all free. I cannot.
This is now. I'm going to be dead.
down. We'll give Indulgus just another moment of your time. Just please be comfortable. A little over 10 years ago, the theatrical community, performers, musicians, backstage crew, house staff, box office, management, all banded together in an organization called Broadway Cares, Equity Fights AIDS, in order to do whatever we could to help battle this deadly plague of our day. Broadway Cares, Equity Fights AIDS provides food, clothing, shelter, medical supplies to those men, women, and children living with AIDS. We'll continue to help. But as you leave this evening, you'll be passing a number of my colleagues at the exit plan. And as you do so, please reach into your hearts. Do whatever you can. There are approximately 1,000 seats in this house, and if each person would give just $1, the effect would be immeasurable. We're also selling some show posters that are signed by the entire cast for a contribution of $50 or more, and all proceeds will go directly to Broadway Cares, Equity Fights AIDS. I thank you in advance for your contributions. I thank you so much for your time. Good night.